education was typical bachelor fine arts. It gave me a basic background in ceramics and sculpture and photography. There was a workshop where a potter came in from, I think it was New Hampshire, and showed slides of where he lived, and it was a rural place, and had what looked like, you know, very romantic life. So that kind of triggered this notion that, you know, maybe it would be possible to actually have a life that included making objects for sale in a rural place. So when we moved here, we were confronted with a 300-acre farm with 11 buildings, most of, well, some, about half of which were in pretty derelict condition. So it was kind of what we call back to the land boot camp. We became pretty active environmentally. Probably we could have been a lot more active, but it's been a concern really since we were in our early 20s. And that has kind of informed a lot of things we do and the way we look at the world and probably our work as well. A lot of my work deals with fragmentation, kind of this idea of taking things that are broken and restoring them to what might have been their former selves. Part of that comes from haunting museums and seeing reconstructed artifacts and having a sense that those reconstructions in some ways were probably as or more interesting than what they looked like when they were brand new. I crave change and excitement in my life. And one of the ways that's expressed in my working life is this notion of transformation by fire. That became apparent to me fairly early when building kilns and whatnot. The raku in particular was it's a really visceral activity. You are very present. There is no question. You're not worrying about your bank loan or, you know, your list, your to-do list is out the window when you've got a red-hot pot in your hand with gloves that aren't quite up to holding it, and you're moving it from point A to point B with flames going around your head, eyebrows gone, and all that stuff. That's pretty exciting, and I like that being at the edge of the possible. One of the things I have done for quite a while is included glyphs, usually things that I just make up. It's made up language in a felt way rather than in a literal way. And I've experimented a bit with using, you know, English words and letters, but that gets in the way. I'm not a writer, I'm a visual artist. Then there's also that connection with this notion of an historical past, you know, from the new to the old, and from the understood to the mysterious, and where that mystery comes from. I like that the theme of transformation. I like it in the work as well as in the process. I work in a lot of materials. I think the nice way to say it is I'm curious and enjoy experimenting. It's just kind of following my nose. I started working with glass in around 1980-81 when I spent a year living in Providence, Rhode Island. And it intrigued me. I mean, it has this potential for luminosity and kind of mimicking air and water that is really nice in combination with other materials, particularly I found with bronze. There are natural influences in my work, and some of them are becoming more obvious. The latest bunch of work I had, I think it's quite obvious. I've got sticks as a motif that I think is just an obvious symbol for nature.